This is a piece in progress, actually. I'm actually not sure what it's going to be like. So I will wait to see what this piece becomes. I'm Mark Zellhoff. I am a sculptor, and I've been a sculptor for 50 years. This is one of my studio spaces. I always walk down here and kind of amazed that I did this work. I like this piece because I like the weight of it, the size of it. I like how the stuffed animals are being squished. I immediately envision this piece, these stuffed animals being crushed by this monolithic, heavy piece. They're being crushed, contained, trying to escape. I have no idea why I wanted stuffed animals. I wasn't deprived of stuffed animals. My parents didn't take away my stuffed animals. It's childhood, it's innocence, under pressure, being crushed. Maybe that's what happens in childhood. People bring a lot of feelings to them. They are colorful, where a lot of my work doesn't use color. It's pretty cheerful in terms of the color. And I've used stuffed animals by the thousands. So where do I get them from? I get them from thrift stores, secondhand stores. There was a time where I bought one or two bags of stuffed animals and the store cut me off. And I said, could you tell me why? And they said, no, I'm sorry, but we've been told we can't sell you stuffed animals. I'm actually leery and suspect of art that is pretty and beautiful. I think art has to be authentic. This piece is made out of an envelope, actually, with some human hair, and I saw it as a vagina. I also want my work to be an expression of my unconscious. It just kind of popped up and spontaneously happened. I don't purposely intend my work to be hostile or angry or frightening to people, but I know that it is. This is a piece that I did, and when I finished, I identified it as a self-portrait. But I don't see myself like that. I think I'm just speaking for parts of some people when I make the art. There's a piece that I have of a metal spike on a stool. What my wife says about my work is, if she didn't know me, she may not want to be in the same room with me. This is a stuffed animal that is very vulnerable. The clothespins certainly inflict some pain. Maybe my wife was right. Maybe she shouldn't be in the same room with me. I don't know. The pieces that I do for indoor are actually very fragile, and I sometimes worry about them. Using cardboard boxes, strapping tape, things wrapped and entwined, held together. I think about death a lot. Maybe that is the reason that I make sculpture. This piece is 40 years in the making. My outdoor pieces are my outdoor pieces, different from my indoor pieces. Yes, just by the nature that it's steel, so it's a broader brushstroke that I'm making it. I love the quality of rusted steel. It oxidizes, and I love that process, that it changes and weathers. I love the weight. I love that they are permanent. I did a small model about 40 years ago, and this piece I was able to resurrect from the model, and it is about 6 months old. Now you will see my first piece is actually one of my favorites. This was the altar that God told Abraham to sacrifice his son. This piece was originally intended for an indoor piece. Eventually it landed in here. It's the perfect spot for it. Who would have imagined? This piece uses color as an important element for it working. It's dented, it's rusted, looks like it's been through the war. And you could make your own story about why it's tethered together. One of my fears about being an artist is what happens to my work when I die. And that dark part of me kind of pictures a dumpster rolling up and in it goes. And then the part of me realizes I'm dead. It makes no difference, actually.